The iPhone 17 Pro may operate on a much better processor than the iPhone 17 and Galaxy S25. This year's Apple iPhone 17 series has a remote possibility of being supported by a 2nm processor. It was formerly assumed that all iPhone 17 variants will operate on semiconductors based on Taiwan semiconductor manufacturing company 3rd generation 3nm process and 3P. The iPhone 16 runs on TSMC 2nd generation 3nm and 3E processors. Although generational jumps provide performance and efficiency improvements, they are minor, particularly in relation to changes to new process nodes. DigiTimes said TSMC will begin mass-producing 2nm chips in the second part of the year, with Apple being the first client in line. The site implies that not only the Pro versions, but also one of the two regular iPhone 17 variants, probably the Air, will include a 2nm processor. The manufacturing capacity is restricted, which is why the standard model will continue utilizing a 3nm processor. Chips based on the new innovation are also likely to be more costly, which appears to explain why the 2nm chip will be kept for the costlier versions. The most sophisticated semiconductor technology now on the market is TSMC 2nm, which provides up to 15% faster speed or up to 30% better efficiency relative to 3nm. Given analyst Ming-Chae Kuo just predicted next year's iPhone 18 will be the first Apple phone to have a 2nm technology, this is an unexpected turn of events. Before then, it was stated that only the iPhone 18 Pro and Pro Max will change to a next-generation processor architecture. DigiTimes doesn't have a great track record, so it's best to take this rumor with a grain of salt. Even without a 2nm CPU, the iPhone 17 Pro will undoubtedly be a big boost, owing to a redesigned back design with a pixel-like camera bar, a 48-megapixel periscope camera, and overhauled iOS 19. That said, a 2nm CPU might offer the phone a major advantage over top Android phones like as Galaxy S25, which utilize 3nm chips and will likely arrive. It may seem like the iPhone 16 only just arrived, presumably because we're still waiting for those long-teased Apple Intelligence features, but the iPhone 17 and iPhone 17 Pro are anticipated to come in less than 6 months, and the gossip mill isn't slowing down. Speculation regarding the iPhone 17 began long before the iPhone 16 even released, with early reports pointing to an ultra-thin model called the iPhone 17 Air, which would replace the iPhone 17 Plus. Leaks about the incoming device have only gained speed since. While part of Apple's team is still struggling with the impact from its delayed, artificially intelligent Siri, now due to appear in the coming year, the tech giant is also busy putting the final touches on the iPhone 17. But will it live up to the hype? Apple iPhone price speculations are seldom all that trustworthy. Every year, leakers and experts warn us that the iPhone would be going up in price, but they end up keeping the same. Could that change this year? Once again, an insider said on X, previously Twitter, in December 2024 that iPhone 17 pricing will be going higher this year. Jong-Wook Lee, a senior researcher at Samsung Securities Research Center, stated that Apple's iPhone pricing were supposed to increase last year with the iPhone 16, but they didn't, leading to profit margins taking a blow, and so the analyst anticipates prices to climb for the iPhone 17 range. However, the iPhone 17 Air, which is anticipated to replace Apple's plus-size variant, could be cheaper than many think. According to a rumor released by Bloomberg's Mark Gurman in March, the phone would cost the same price as the iPhone 16 Plus. That's $899 in the US and £899 in the UK. A welcome rumor, if it's true. I'd take iPhone price speculations with a grain of salt. The iPhone 16 costs £799, the iPhone 16 Plus costs £899, the iPhone 16 Pro costs £999, and the iPhone 16 Pro Max costs £1,199. The iPhone 17 range will likely cost the same. In an August 2024 report, Jeff Poo stated in a research note that all four iPhone 17 models would include a 24-megapixel front-facing camera, a superior lens than the 12-megapixel front-facing camera on the iPhone 16. It's a rumor made by trusted leaker Ming-Chae Kuo back in January 2024. And in October 2024, Poo noted that the iPhone 17 Pro will sport a 48-megapixel telephoto shooter. In February 2025, Majin Buu revealed fresh renderings of the iPhone 17 range, this time featuring the camera array. In the renderings, the iPhone 17 Pro and iPhone 17 Pro Max may be seen having a triple camera system set horizontally over the top. The standard iPhone 17 will keep to its two vertical cameras, while the iPhone 17 Air will sport only one single camera. Mark Gurman predicted in March 2025 that this would be a 48 megapixels camera on the iPhone 17 Air. While you may believe that a smaller iPhone 17 Air would imply a lower battery life, Mark Gurman reports that the battery life of the iPhone 17 Air will be on par with current iPhones, presumably the entry-level iPhone 16. With reports pointing to a thinner iPhone 17 Air, design adjustments throughout the lineup and possible enhancements, like a 48 megapixels front camera and promotion, seeping down to non-pro versions, the iPhone 17 might signal one of the most exciting updates in years, assuming the leaks hold true. Pricing appears poised to keep the same, but the transition back to aluminium on the Pro versions would feel like a step down, and the anticipated design change might be extremely divisive. And of course, Apple's delayed intelligence features still hang in the balance. Next, the iPhone 17 Air is projected to reinvent Apple's smartphone portfolio with its focus on portability, creative design, and performance advancements. Expected to arrive in 2025, this model is said to blend revolutionary technology with a minimalist approach, giving a simplified experience for those that favor ease and efficiency. The iPhone 17 Air is reported to be Apple's thinnest smartphone to yet, measuring only 5.5 millimeters at its slimmest point. Even with the presence of a camera bump, the gadget retains a tiny profile at just 9.5 millimeters thick. This ultra-thin design is supposed to make the phone extraordinarily lightweight and simple to carry, appealing to those who value mobility. To suit its small form factor, Apple is allegedly going for a single rear camera arrangement. This signals a break from the multi-lens systems found in prior models, signifying a trend toward simplicity without losing key functions. The design is expected to connect with people who seek a clean, minimalist gadget that doesn't compromise usefulness. The iPhone 17 Air is likely to include a single 48 megapixels wide back camera, offering high-quality photographs while simplifying the entire hardware. On the front, a 24 megapixels camera is reported to double the quality of previous models, making sure crisper selfies and clearer video calls. While this camera arrangement may not appeal to expert photographers or those wanting sophisticated photography capabilities, it is meant to fulfill the demands of ordinary consumers. The emphasis on portability and simplicity makes it an appealing alternative for folks who favor ease of use over sophisticated camera systems. For the first time in a non-pro iPhone, the iPhone 17 Air is reported to contain a 6.6-inch ProMotion OLED display. This new screen technology is supposed to enable speedier scrolling, more responsive touch interactions, and an overall better user experience. The OLED display is also projected to deliver brilliant colors and deep blacks, making it suitable for activities like as streaming, gaming, and ordinary browsing. By putting ProMotion technology into a mid-range model, Apple is widening access to capabilities formerly reserved for its premium smartphones. The iPhone 17 Air is likely to include a high-density carbon battery, enabling a smaller form without losing battery life. This innovative battery technology is claimed to boost energy efficiency, letting users to enjoy extended use hours even while running demanding applications or utilizing connection capabilities like 5G and Wi-Fi 7. This idea offers a huge step forward in balancing performance with portability. Users may anticipate a smartphone that not only feels lightweight, but also offers solid battery performance throughout the day. The iPhone 17 Air is expected to feature both 5G and Wi-Fi 7, making sure speedier and more stable connectivity. These connection advancements are meant to match the expectations of current consumers, whether they are streaming high-resolution material, engaging in video chats, or gaming online. By adopting the newest networking standards, Apple is marketing the iPhone 17 Air as a gadget that can keep pace with the increasingly connected world. This functionality is expected to appeal to consumers who depend on their cell phones for smooth communication and entertainment. At the core of the iPhone 17 Air is the expected A19 CPU combined with 8 gigs of RAM. This combination is anticipated to give smoother multitasking, quicker app launches, and enhanced overall performance. While it may not equal the sheer power of Apple's Pro models, the hardware is more than capable of performing daily work and modest gaming. The A19 processor highlights Apple's dedication to offering high-performance devices throughout its portfolio. Users can anticipate a responsive and efficient experience, whether they are surfing the web, streaming movies, or using productivity applications. The iPhone 17 Air looks to be targeted for those that favor mobility and a small appearance above sophisticated photography functions or professional-grade performance. It is a good alternative for anyone wanting a lightweight tablet with solid performance, a high-quality display, and novel networking. This device is expected to appeal to a broad spectrum of customers, from casual users who desire ease to those who admire Apple's minimalist design philosophy. While it may not appeal to skilled photographers or power users, the iPhone 17 Air delivers a tempting combination for the typical customer. So, that's all we know for now. We'll be sure to keep you updated as soon as we have more information. Thanks for watching. Peace out.